Oh, look, someone's come to play. You have come to play, haven't you? We're playing a guessing game. It's better with more people. Kitty and me, of course. You don't see anyone else here, do you? Anyway, you should go if you're not going to play. Kitty finds you distracting. I can't go. Kitty says she can't come, and I'm not leaving her. She'd be lonely.
You are so kind, Amalia. I would miss you dearly if you left.
Of course she's a cat. She just talks, that's all.
Talking is simple enough, once you know how.
Oh, bug whistles, you're just no fun. I'm going to ignore you now.
Nothing you say will convince Amalia to go with you. She loves only me now. I am her friend, while you are just a stranger. It seems we are at an impasse, so let me propose a compromise of sorts. Release me, mortal, and let me have the girl. Let us return to her father and leave this place forever. Mortals often allow themselves to be blinded by hope. They see what they wish to see. If the father hopes to see his Amalia alive and unharmed, perhaps he will. Thank you. You are very gracious. The mage's wards hold me within this chamber, and only a mortal may approach them. There is a trick to disarming the wards, but I do not know it. Perhaps you will succeed where the girl failed.
Oh, this is so exciting! Kitty is going to be free! I've always wanted a cat, and Kitty is so perfect and pretty. When Kitty thinks me. Father doesn't like cats, but he never met Kitty. Grandpa Wilhelm locked her up in this room. Isn't that awful? He's my best friend.
The magic fading. Oh, I had forgotten how it feels not to be caged.
Kitty, what's happening?
A wonderful thing, my dear, for both of us. Betrayal! You will not take the girl. She is mine!
Kitty, you're scaring me! I won't let you inside me! I won't!